I'm Holly Maloney, and today I'm at the Ensemble Theater in Cincinnati, and I have my special guest, Lauren Carr, who is the Director of Education and Outreach. How are you, Lauren?
Good, Holly. How are you?
Great. Thanks for having me today.
Well, thank you for coming.
Well, I love this theater, as you know. I come to most all the productions. It is, you can see the best actors in Cincinnati at the Ensemble. I just love coming here. So today we're sitting at the table of the Mad Hatter's Tea Party, and I want to discuss a little bit about your Fairy Godmother program that you have here.
So the Fairy Godmother program is an opportunity for us to be able to provide tickets and snacks and transportation to underserved schools and communities in Cincinnati to come and see our holiday show free of charge.
That's nice. And your holiday show is
Alice in Wonderland.
So that's why we're at the tea party. The Fairy Godmother program, how exactly did that get started?
25 years ago, we lost who we consider to be Ensemble's Fairy Godmother. Her name was Jenny Hoffman, and we lost her to ovarian cancer. And after her passing, we started the Fairy Godmother program. Doing the kids' shows and performances was her favorite thing that she got to do, and she was one of the founding members of the Ensemble company. It started with about 10, 12 kids coming to see the shows, and it has grown over the past 25 years to this year we were able to provide over 1,700 tickets.
Wow, 1,700 tickets to the matinee shows that you have here.
And this year, in addition, we have done 2 sensory-friendly performances. So those are for people with autism and other developmental disabilities. And one of those performances, we actually made an evening for the students to be able to attend with their families.
Oh, nice. And what exactly is sensory?
With the sensory-friendly performance, we turn up the house lights a little bit so no one feels fully in the dark. We tone down the stage lights a little bit so no one's overwhelmed by that. We adjust the sound here and there, and we're completely relaxed the house rules. So if the families need to, or the students need to get up and leave because they're having a bad moment, they can absolutely do so. They can come and go as they please and enjoy the show in the way that is most comfortable and natural for them.
Oh, that's wonderful. I haven't heard of any other theaters around that do something like that. This is wonderful.
We've been doing them here for, this is our 5th year, and since some of the other theaters are starting to do them as well, and it's becoming a national movement, just not as quickly as it should be.
I agree. So the Fairy Godmother program, you get donations from individuals, and how would one donate?
There is a link on our website to donate for the Fairy Godmother program, and then also after each performance, the actors go out into the lobby and will collect any loose change that might be weighing you down.
Okay.
And that all goes into our Fairy Godmother fund in order to, for the next year, pay for those performances and to pay those local actors and provide the busing and snacks.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah, that's what my next question is, because you provide all the buses, not just the show, but also the buses to get the children to and from the theater.
Yeah, we're working with schools that really don't have funding for field trips or for extra things, especially around the holidays. There's a lot going on in every school program. So if we can provide a field trip with an extra bonus of them not even having to pay to scrape up and, you know, do the bake sales to get the money for the bus, you know, our extra little thing is giving snacks at intermission.
Oh, that's wonderful. Because most of these kids, I would imagine most of them would never ever get to see a theater production like this if not were.
Most of them, we are their first and only theatrical experience.
Oh, fabulous, fabulous. So the school, how do you pick the schools?
So we have an online application that goes up in the late spring, and the schools will fill out and apply with their parameters of why they are eligible for the program. So depending on their percentage of free or reduced lunches, what subsidies their school is already receiving, and if they have a history with us as well. Okay. So a lot of these schools have been coming to the Fairy Godmother program for many years.
They know
exactly when the application goes online, and they are first to get it in.
I can imagine. If I were a teacher, that's one thing I would do for my children as well. Well, I appreciate today. I appreciate you having me, and I know this performance goes on through the end of the month.
It goes until the 30th.
To the 30th. Mm-hmm. Great. So if you haven't been down here to see Alice in Wonderland, it's a big treat. Thanks for having me.
Thank you so much.
And back to the studio.